Hello, and welcome to the PLYMC's Library Anywhere podcast, where we discuss books, programs, and all things library-related in Youngstown and Mahoning County. Welcome back to our PLYMC Anywhere podcast. I am Rhonda.
And I'm Kelly. Hi, everyone. So, it's a new year.
And also a new you.
For our first podcast of the year 2023, we're going to discuss self-improvement for the new year.
Oh, self-improvement, Kelly, do you mean New Year's resolutions?
Well, yeah, in a way. Because a New Year's resolution is a kind of promise that you make to yourself, usually intended to help us improve ourselves and live better lives. But just at the start of the new year.
I see. Well, you know that New Year's resolutions, they've been around for a long time. Some say that ancient Babylonians were the first to make New Year's resolutions some 4,000 years ago.
Wow.
So people would make promises to their gods to pay their debts and return borrowed items. And they thought, you know, if they kept their promises, they'd be on the good side of their gods. And of course, if they didn't keep their promises, they'd be on their bad side.
Or other sources say it could have been ancient Rome or the medieval period, where people were making vows and promises and recommitments to do noble things.
Well, I tell you what, whenever it started, at the very least by the 19th century moving forward, making resolutions, it was commonplace, and people would make these resolutions and sometimes fail to keep them, which of course I can say that I'm guilty here. And because of this, this habit of making resolutions became satirized, being made fun of and criticized through satire.
Why? So what we do know for sure, we have had New Year's resolutions for over 200 years. And despite the roots of this tradition, where promises were made to God or their gods, it has become secular today. And people make resolutions to themselves, with the focus being on self-improvement.
And you know, we also know, much like today, people use them as an excuse for, I guess I can say, misbehavior up to New Year's Eve. Like, for instance, like pigging out prior to making a commitment. I know I've done that. I'm like, okay, I'm going to eat all I can eat in sight, because starting January 1st, you know, everything's over. I can't do all this. I'm going to stuff myself. So, you know, some people may do something like that prior to starting, you know, a diet on January 1st. But for me, I personally think it would just be easier to start somewhere in December so that you won't be starting from scratch on January 1st, like cold turkey. And I know I can't do cold turkey, but, you know, I know for some people, cold turkey might be the way to go.
Yeah, well, I know I usually have to ease my way into things. That always works best for me.
Yeah, I agree. Well, let me ask you this, Kelly. Are you making any New Year's resolutions?
Well, no surprise here, but I think I'll stick to my usual New Year's resolution: to lose weight.
Okay.
Or rather, to live a healthier lifestyle with better diet and exercise.
Yes, that sounds good. And of course, that's an old favorite.
It sure is. And I know I'm not alone. Year after year, being healthier is consistently one of the most popular New Year's resolutions, whether that's eating healthier, exercising more, or losing weight.
And, you know, I was looking at a website, Statista.com, and it listed America's top New Year's resolutions for 2023. So I'm going to ask you, what do you think were the top five? And just for the record, what you just mentioned, eating healthier, exercising more, losing weight, are the top three. So can you guess what the other two might be?
Oh, wow. I already got three out of five. My guess, my other guess would be, making more money, and traveling more.
Okay. Those are among the list. The next one was to save more money.
Ha.
Still had to do with money. And then the other one was to spend more time with family and friends. So those are like the top five. But some of the other ones that were included was to spend less time on social media or to watch less TV, which I think those are really good. Maybe quit drinking, smoking, things like that, find a new job. So there were quite a few different things, but yeah, those were the top five.
Oh, wow. Those are really interesting. And those are really good resolutions too.
Yeah, they are. Mm-hmm.
So, well, I hope they all have really good luck with those resolutions, because I know I'm optimistic that this is the year that I'm going to keep my resolution. I'm going to keep my resolution to get healthier.
Well, that's a good one though. I'm with you on that. Do you think you might have better success if you looked at it through the lens of self-improvement instead of resolutions?
Ooh, I bet you're right. Because I read somewhere that of the 41% of Americans who make New Year's resolutions, that by the end of the year, only 9% were successful in keeping them.
Oh, wow. That's a very low percent, and that's not good.
I know. And even worse, as every week goes by, the success rate of keeping your New Year's resolution drops significantly.
Oh, well, let me just say this. I'm so ashamed, but I know that I am part of the statistics. I hate to say it. So for me initially, you know, I'm really hyped and I'm really wanting to do the right thing. And then as time goes by, as you mentioned, I'm not as focused and, you know, I've not been successful at all at reaching my goals. As you know, I can imagine that, you know, there seems to be lots of reasons why people aren't successful at reaching their goals.
Yeah, I was reading about some of them. Some of the reasons were setting unrealistic goals, failing to keep track of progress, and my favorite was just plain forgetting about their resolutions.
Oh my. Well, you know, thinking about unrealistic goals, this is definitely a drawback. And I know this has been a problem for me at times in the past. You know, I just had to tell myself to think realistically. Okay, you want to lose 50 pounds, but you're not going to do it in 2 weeks. So, you know, like I said, I have to tell myself to think realistically and kind of go from there. And so I think this is how we have to think so that we are more successful at reaching our goals.
Yeah.
But going back, hold up for a second. I know you said that people forgot about the resolutions that they made.
No, that's weird, right? They just straight up forgot.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah. And then there's like 1 in 10 people who failed the resolutions because they said they made too many resolutions.
Oh, okay.
It's so hard to remember them.
Yeah. Yeah. Right. And that explains probably why some people don't even bother to make New Year's resolutions anymore.
Yeah. That can be a little disheartening.
Yeah, but I bet that focusing on self-improvement is better after all, because self-improvement, you know, is an activity or a goal that enhances your quality of life, helping you to reach your full potential.
You know, that just sounds much more positive, more optimistic, more hopeful than like a serious New Year's resolution.
Right. And fortunately, you know, the library is all about self-improvement and we've got tons of things to help you live your best life. And that's so exciting. And things like self-improvement books.
You know, in our catalog, I saw we have almost 1,000 books about self-improvement. In fact, I found 20 books alone with just the title of self-improvement.
Oh, that's awesome. And you know, any book on self-help counts too. And we have hundreds of those.
Mm-hmm. Plus we've got books on exercise and cookbooks for healthy eating.
Now, those are books that I really enjoy looking through and reading. You know, I've always had an interest in health as it relates to, you know, being a healthy person, whether it has to do with prevention or reading about better eating habits or certain foods that can be beneficial to your health. And I definitely love reading about exercising. And, you know, I like getting in all the tips for exercising and the different moves that you can do. Mm-hmm. And that brings me to workout DVDs that we do have in our collection as well that can definitely be used for self-improvement.
Oh, cool. And you know, in addition to exercise videos, we have DVDs on other improving topics as well.
Yeah, that's right. Like learning a new language, documentaries, fun educational videos for you and your kids.
Yeah. And you can also improve your life by taking a class with the library, like hands-on educational classes at our library branches every month. We have lots of computer literacy classes, including basic computers, basic email, Microsoft Word, Zoom. And for those of you who may not know it, we have a service called Book a Librarian for if you need some one-on-one, in-person, hands-on help. This is where librarians meet one-on-one with new patrons for help with things like research, setting up your device for ebooks, even improving your resume. All you need to do is call us to set up your book librarian appointment.
Yeah, it's that simple. And I often find myself booking appointments with senior citizens, and they come in a lot because they want to learn how to navigate their cell phones. You know, with all the new technology, they're just not familiar with it. And so they always say they need help with doing this so that they can become knowledgeable and confident with using their cell phones. And I think it's wonderful, you know, that they even want to come in and learn, you know, and become confident in learning how to use their cell phones. And they want to improve and take, you know, whatever necessary steps to do so. And so I think this is a perfect example of self-improvement.
Yes, it certainly is. We can also cover lots of other useful and fun topics like using Libby and Hoopla, our apps, working with the makerspace, doing your genealogy, and even learning how to find grants and write business proposals.
Yeah, there's so many different areas, you know, that you can look at as it relates to self-improvement. So, you know, all the things that we've mentioned, I think are all great things that, you know, everybody can take advantage of. And you can also find virtual classes on our website. You just visit www.libraryvisit.org, which is our website, and just find our list of online resources.
A couple of my favorites are Universal Class and North Star Digital Literacy. Mm-hmm. These each have lots and lots of cool classes that you can take, and they're all free with your library card.
Yes, free is the key word. So yes. I hope everybody takes advantage. North Star Digital Literacy is especially good with computer classes, you know, especially if you need to beef up your essential computer skills or just improve your software skills like Microsoft Word, Excel, and Google Docs.
And you can also earn continuing education units, those are CEUs, for each class that you pass.
Wow, that's so cool.
Yes.
And you know, that would be something you'd want to show your boss or your potential employer to demonstrate that, you know, you have the skills that it takes to get a job. And in the very end, I mean, you can just feel good about yourself all the way around.
Oh, totally. Mm-hmm. Hey, Rhonda, do you know what else the library helps with?
What would that be?
Reading.
Of course.
And you know, reading is always good for you.
Definitely. It is always good for you. It improves yourself by expanding your mind.
Absolutely. And you know, it's really my favorite kind of workout.
What good workout. And yes, it's so much fun.
You betcha. And the library has got lots of stuff to read.
I mean, lots and lots and lots. So there's no excuse for anyone. And you did you know you can use the library website to track all the books you read and all the books you want to read, kind of like Goodreads?
Oh, I love that. I love keeping lists of my books. You know, Goodreads is a fun website too. I'm doing the annual reading challenge.
Oh, how does that work?
Well, you log into your Goodreads account, you set the number of books that you want to read each year, and it tracks your progress for you.
Oh, wow. That's nice. And you know what? I can see that really motivating you or anyone to read more.
Yeah, actually it does.
And I think that'll keep you inspired for sure and moving forward all year long.
Yes, that's right. It's a really great way to keep up with your resolution.
Hold on. You mean self-improvement?
Oh, you know what I mean.
Okay. Well, I tell you what, that's what we wanted to discuss with you on today regarding self-improvement in the new year. And I want to say for those of us who are committing to self-improvement, including myself, you know, I just want to take the time out to encourage us all to take the necessary steps to do so. You know, I want us to stay focused, you know, and just have fun and enjoy the journey and never, ever give up, because you know what? We've got this.
Well said. So thank you all for joining us, and we hope that you join us again next time.
Be well and be safe. Bye. Bye.
Thank you for joining us this month at PLYMC's Library Anywhere podcast. Make sure to visit our website at www.libraryvisit.org, where you could always find more great things the library offers. If you enjoyed this episode, please share it with others. Also, check out our Instagram feed or follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube at PLYMC. You can also find us on TikTok at ThePLYMC. And be sure to tune in next month for our next episode. And thanks for listening.